So last session, we left off more or less here, where we generated the lines to generate the pattern. But as you can see, the lines are not completed yet. There's some gaps within the lines. We're going to solve in a second. So let's do a recap really fast. So we used the lunchbox plugin to generate really fast the hexagons, as you can see here. And what we did then is to split those hexagons into the inner ones and the outer ones. And from those hexagons, we only choose a certain ones, which are these four. So we're not going to get confused by the rest of the hexagons. I mean, if we solve it for these four, we solve it for the other ones. So what we did then is to actually get the center point. And we got another point on the same line. And this is going to be... This was going to be the one in charge of, let's say, the rotation. So let's switch it to 0.75. So the only thing missing is to, like I said, to complete the hexagon into a closed curve. So this is actually quite easy. We just need to use these lines we just generated again and find the intersection between those lines. And then we can simply create a polyline through all the points we have generated. So simply copy the two shift lists again. Simply select them both and type in Ctrl C, Ctrl V. And let's connect them to the line output. So the component we want to use now is Intersect Line. So you can go to the Intersect tab and go to Mathematical, because it's not an actual intersection. It's more or less like a mathematical intersection. So there's a component for that called Line-Line Intersection. So simply insert that component and connect the L to the A and the other L to the B. And as you can see now on the Rhino canvas, you see like some extra connection points got inserted, and I select them now. So those are the green points, and those are exactly the points we need to complete our hexagonal shape. So simply let's switch off our line component. Let's also switch off the point on curve component. Nice. So these are exactly the points we need to complete a hexagon. So the only thing we need to do now is to actually draw a polyline through these points. So simply double click the canvas again and type in polyline. And connect the PA or PB, doesn't really matter. You can connect both of them to the V. And as you can see, the polyline got nicely created. Ah, the only thing missing is to actually set the C to true, because we want it to be a closed polyline, of course. Nice. So this is actually a closed polyline, which is pretty cool, because now, as you can see, we can actually switch this line to 0.5. And we have our pattern, the one we want. But it's cool because you can actually use this definition to create other interesting patterns, like the Evolute Pavilion, which is more or less this kind of configuration. And the Centre Pompidou has this slider to 0.5. So now let's insert the whole hexagonal grid to see the final result. So simply go to your dispatch from before. Let's set the explode component to flatten. And let's simply connect the B to that one. If you zoom out in your Rhino canvas, you see that that you have the whole pattern right now. So now we can actually control the spacing and everything by changing the spacing from the hexagons and from the lunchbox component. And also we can actually change the rotation again to see like the final result. Next session, we're going to cull out the parts of the pattern we won't be needing, looking at the floor plan from the Centre Pompidou. And also, we're going to adjust the spacing so it matches up with the amount of structural lines we have in the floor plan. So stick around.